Would you like to learn about the process to design a cloud architecture or enterprise architecture? If so, this video is for you. This video is another episode in our series about the cloud architecture and enterprise architecture process. In this video, we'll be continuing the discussion about the process to design an architecture that will drive digital transformation. Specifically, we will introduce Phase F of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework. At GoCloud Careers, we are a member of the Open Group and we leverage the TOGAF framework. We like it as it provides a structured and repeatable approach to designing cloud and enterprise architectures that drive digital transformation. We like the TOGAF framework as it's an industry standard, which is used by most major players in the enterprise architecture space, like IBM, Microsoft, Dell, Intel, VMware, Accenture, Deloitte, PricewaterhouseCoopers, Cognizant, and many other key organizations. Going back to TOGAF, Phase F is about finalizing the architecture roadmap. Phase F is about ensuring that the implementation and migration plan is coordinated with the enterprise's approach to implement change. It's also about ensuring the business value and costs are understood and accepted by key stakeholders. If you haven't seen the videos on developing an architecture vision, developing the business architecture, developing the data architecture, developing the technology architecture, or finding opportunities and solutions, you can find these TOGAF videos in the description of this video. Now we will be discussing Phase F of the TOGAF Enterprise Architecture Framework. This phase begins with harmonizing the architecture and the migration strategy to the management frameworks in the organization. Now, when we've discussed management frameworks, what we're really discussing is how the architecture will be integrated into the following components of the overall business. Now, this includes business planning, which is really responsible for conceiving, directing, and providing resources for activities for the business to achieve their objectives. It also fits into enterprise architecture, which is really the structure and context of all enterprise activities to deliver concrete business outcomes. It falls into the project and portfolio management realm, which is responsible for planning and constructing business systems that produce specific business results. And it also falls into the operations management framework, which is about the people, the processes, and technology that enable the business to run and run efficiently. Now, after the analysis, the implementation and migration plan is integrated into these critical business functions. Obviously, this means lots of discussions with key stakeholders throughout the various levels of the organization and creating more documentation. Remember, technology will have an impact on every component of the business, and the goal of any technology project is not the technology, but it's to drive and improve business performance. Next, we need to assign a business value to every set of tasks. We need to evaluate how the technology will affect the business, what financial gain is going to be expected from this new architecture. I always like to say that no company buys technology because they like it. They invest in technology to drive business performance. And therefore, we need to quantify the value that technology will provide and make sure that the investment is worth it. We will also need to establish metrics for success to evaluate the success of the project and make better predictions for future technology investments. We also need to define what the organization considers valuable and also how to measure it. And we also need to evaluate the business value of each project and its stages. What this means is we really have to do the following: set up key success factors to determine the success of each project phase. Assign risk to projects and project phases. We have to estimate the business value for each project, and of course, evaluate the resources and timeframe needed for each project and its stages. We must also give preliminary cost estimates, both for the implementation of the new systems, but also the management and maintenance ongoing of the systems. We also need to quantify opportunities where the cost of the new systems can be mitigated by shutting down old systems or current systems that may no longer be needed. We have to prioritize and rank projects by weighing their business value against their delivery cost. We must ensure that the risks have been properly identified and, of course, managed. Lastly, we need to get stakeholder agreement and allocate the necessary resources for the project to be successful. The The last part of phase F of the TOGAF architecture development method is related to finalizing the implementation and migration plan. Here we develop the final plan for implementation and migration. We combine all of this collected information using recognized planning and management methods. We incorporate the projects, the tasks, the dependencies, and their effects of change into an inclusive project plan. We then document and install RO documents in the architecture repository for future use. Of course, this is a high-level overview. If you would like to have a deeper understanding of this, make sure to look at our training content. The link is in the description below. To learn how to get your first cloud architect job, please download the free ebook and join us in the free webinar on how to become the ultimate cloud architect. If you've enjoyed this video, please let's give the video a like. Please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos and new opportunities to assist you in your cloud architecture or enterprise architecture career.